Here are the 20 most incredible Champions League moments.
There's all the jinx. Oh, he slipped.
And how about this volley from 50 meters distance? In 2011, Schalke played against Inter Milan. Neuer does a diving header. And Dejan Stankovic just takes a shot. What a goal, but nothing compared to our top three. For example, the craziest red card ever.
I don't believe it.
We are in 2005. Barcelona played Chelsea at the Stamford Bridge. Chelsea had already scored three goals. Barca only one. The ball gets to Ronaldinho.
Oh, it's a terrific goal.
Unbelievable. He does a quick dance and then shoots with the front of his boot. Cech could only watch how the ball goes into the net. But it still wasn't enough. Chelsea kicked Ronaldinho and the rest of Barca out of the tournament. But this unforgettable moment remains. Just like our number 18. In 2018, Liverpool played Paris Saint-Germain. Everyone was looking forward to the game. And as with every Champions League match, there was a press conference before it. Jürgen Klopp, the coach of Liverpool, faced the reporters. And when a French reporter asked him a question, it was translated for him.
Very erotic voice, by the way, translator. Wow. Again, please.
The Champions League is pure emotion, and that includes heartbreaking moments like this one. Final 2008 in Moscow. Manchester United with Ronaldo played against Chelsea. Ronaldo put the Reds in the lead, but Lampard equalized. After extra time, there was no winner, penalty, shootout. And at first, everything looked good for Chelsea. Ronaldo missed, the Blues were in the lead. Then Terry stepped up, the captain and one of Chelsea's most reliable players.
Terry to win it.
One of the saddest pictures of the Champions League. But our number 15 is one of the most beautiful. We are back in the Champions League final, again with Manchester United. This time against Barcelona in 2011. And in the starting 11 was Eric Abidal, which was a little miracle. Several months earlier, a tumor was discovered in his liver. It was removed 2 days later, and the doctors predicted a long pause from football. But just 2 months later, he fought his way back and was playing in a match against Getafe. And in the final, he played from the start. Barca won the game 3-1, and before the award ceremony was a special moment. Puyol gave Abidal the captain's armband so that he could be the first one to lift the trophy. That's what Bayern Munich dreamed about back in 1999. They played Manchester United in the final. We are already in overtime and Munich was 1-0 up. A few seconds were left. Manchester was ruthless and scored two goals and ripped Bayern's heart out. What a comeback. But how about this? One of the most incredible saves by a goalkeeper. Jan Oblak saved three shots and Atletico Madrid threw Bayer Leverkusen out of the tournament. And the coach, he probably got a heart attack. But one of the funniest coaching moments was delivered by none other than Jose Mourinho. In 2018, he was the coach of Manchester United. And in the group stage, they faced Young Boys Bern. But Man U was not able to score a goal. We are already in extra time. Fellaini made a last minute goal. And how did Mourinho celebrate it? Yes, he was throwing around the water bottles, which looked pretty banged up afterwards. You know, everyone shows their joy differently. And now to probably the funniest foul ever. Quarterfinal in the 2021 Champions League. Bayern versus PSG. Bayern needed a goal and there was a free kick. Keylor Navas runs into his own teammate and the referee blew the whistle. Foul against Bayern. Müller can hardly believe it. We are in 2016. Real Madrid just won the final in an incredible match against city rival Atletico. Ronaldo scored the last penalty in the shootout and Real Madrid was full of joy. Ah, Ronaldo with his sui. In any case, a funny interview. And our number 10 is one of the most beautiful Champions League goals ever. In November 1999, Florence played against the almighty Barcelona. The ball is cleared from the penalty area. What an overhead kick by Mauro Bressan from about 25 meters distance. Just beautiful to look at. Just like our number 9, the fastest Champions League goal ever. Wow. Roy Mackay just needed 10.12 seconds to score a goal against Madrid in 2007. No surprise the Bayern bench was cheering. But that's nothing compared to the most emotional coach the Champions League has ever seen. Diego Simeone, coach of Atletico Madrid, gave us some funny and scary scenes. I think only Jürgen Klopp can keep up with that. And our number 7 is a goal that only a handful players can make. In 2016, Arsenal played against Ludogorets Razgrad, and in the first 15 minutes, the unbelievable happened. The Bulgarian scored 2 goals, but then Xhaka and Giroud scored the 2-2. Everything looked like a draw, but in the 87th minute, Mesut Özil did this. What a goal. No surprise the fans went crazy. And they often create incredible atmospheres during the Champions League games. How about this one? What a great idea by the Dortmund fans. Or how about this one during the Bayern vs. Lyon match in the 2009 semi-finals? The whole stadium took part in it, and it looks fantastic. But also outside of Germany, they have great ones, like here at Galatasaray Istanbul, and Paris, yeah, they just burn some stuff. Our number 5 is a fun moment when Pep Guardiola forgot which language he was supposed to speak. In 2016, he was the coach of Bayern Munich, and they played Benfica in the quarterfinals. Before the game, he faced questions by the reporters.
Buenas tardes. Reservar un resultado.
Yes, he just started speaking in Spanish. That can happen. Bayern Munich made it to the next round, but then failed in the semifinals against Atletico Madrid. That's when a last-minute goal would have been helpful, like our number 4, an incredible goal by the goalkeeper. Standard Liège played in the Champions League in 2009, but they would not advance past the group stage. The last hope? Secure place 3 to participate in the Europa League. The last game was against Alkmaar, and Liège needed a win or a draw, but they were 0-1 behind. We are already in the 5th minute of overtime. What a header by the goalkeeper. But also, our number 3 is probably one of the most beautiful goals in the Champions League. Bayern played against Barcelona in 2015, and Boateng had the task to stop Messi. Let's see how well that worked out. An unforgettable Champions League moment. It looks so simple. And now to the probably funniest red card ever in a Champions League game. In 2011, Arsenal played against Barcelona in the knockout stage. Arsenal had won the first leg 2-1, and in the 56th minute of the second game, this happened. The referee gave Van Persie a second yellow card for shooting the ball away, and hence Persie had to leave the field. He couldn't believe it. He hadn't heard the whistle and was rightly pissed off during the interview afterwards.
It's just a joke. And he's been bad all evening. He's been a joke all evening. I don't know why he's here tonight. Honestly, I think it's a
Barcelona
joke.
Scored 2 more goals and kicked Arsenal out of the competition. What a bad decision by the referee. And hey, watch out that you don't make a wrong decision by not clicking that subscribe button. And now to our number 1, probably the most impressive comeback ever. We are in the Champions League final 2005. AC Milan and Liverpool faced each other, and Milan had a dream start. Maldini scored in the first minute, and just before halftime, Crespo scored twice. 3-0 at halftime. Everything seemed hopeless, but the Liverpool fans believed in their team and sang "You'll Never Walk Alone." And in the second half, the incredible happened. 3 goals by Liverpool.
In towards Gerrard! By Schmitzer! It's in! All set by Dina Xabi Alonso!
Extra time. And there, Liverpool's goalkeeper made one of the most incredible saves against Shevchenko. And then he saved 3 penalties in the penalty shootout. Liverpool actually turned the game around and won. But if you want to see some of the most heartbreaking moments in football, then watch this video.